My name is Simon.
My name is Christina, and today we are going to present the financial reporting of airlines for the business, which is Flight Central Travel Group. For our examination of the financial report, we have discovered that the Flight Central Travel Group has exhibited trend of upward and downward performance from 2014 to 2016. Firstly, we have noticed that the profit performance for the company has zoomed at $261 million in 2014 financial year, and the figure had rose to $256.55 million for 2015 financial year. The growth indicated an approximately 24% increase in net profit, while the group sales revenue had only increased by approximately 7%. The significantly higher income after taxes is thus indicating that the company has improved its expense control capabilities, allowing the business to return more of this revenue as the final income. However, noting that despite a significant increase in revenue in 2015 and 2016, it has reduced, indicating the worst profitability in the year of 2015 to 2016. The business social performance are majorly fulfilled for two perspectives. Firstly, the company had established Flight Center Foundation. The fund has made philanthropic contributions in the past for imagined. In addition, the foundation is said to have assisted many families in Australia who are struggling to meet with their daily expense budget. Secondly, the business has declared that its social responsibility are fulfilled while facilitating the gender diversity at work. The company alleges that it has appointed 72% for female representatives, and the working places have been designed to encourage greater gender balance, the working life balance for employers. Examining at the financial report of organization, I have noticed that the revenue of the company has significantly increased over the 2 year period. We have observed the company revenue had increased from $2.207 billion to $2.636 billion from 2014 to 2016. The company had facilitated 19.44% growth in its revenue over the 2 years, in which 11.55% was achieved from 2015 to 2016, while the remaining 7.89% was achieved from 2014 to 2015. The trend of disclosing that the company's revenue is increased and consistent and the growth pace, this is a sign of prudent growth, indicating the company's ability to facilitate a consistent expansion. Thus, it has asserted that the difference would be recurring. In addition, it is noted that impairment charges were significantly different from year to year, with 2014 impairment charges value at over $60 million and 2016's impairment charge value at $24 million. There are the non-recurring write-offs that the company incurred over its life. Thus, each of these impairment charges is unique and non-recurring in nature.
The implementation of new lease accounting regulation plans to surface operating leases that are currently not included onto the balance sheet. It's stated the airline industry and the mining industry will be particularly affected by the change. Under the new accounting lease regulation, all lease liabilities will be obligated to be recorded on the balance sheet. the only expansion are short-term leases and the low-value leases, which doesn't exist, the $7,107 in value. In the company's 2016 financial report, it has stated that the change in AASB 16 and its impact on Flight Central Travel Group will be immense. As the business holds a large number of operating leases to facilitate its global shop network, most likely the new lease standard will significantly increase the company's liabilities and the profit as this surface to financial statements. Other than that, it's anticipated that the company will be compelled to increase its asset holding to meet the debit covenant requirements in relation to its leverage or current ratio. The company had reported that for 2016, it had impairment charges of $24.666 million relating to its brand and trademark. The company had expressed that the cash generating units recoverable amount have been determined based on value in use calculations. These calculations use cash flow projection based on management approved financial budget and cover a 4 to 5 years period. The company's payment test are based on many assumptions, including the assumption sold for discount rate. With that in mind, the company's selection of CGU is based on its perception whether the intangible asset will bring value to the organization in the foreseeable future. For the business, it's notable that it has two different types of property, plant and equipment, being buildings and plant and equipment. For the buildings, it's 30 years useful life, and the plant and equipment has 2 to 8 years useful life. The financial report has demonstrated that the asset have measured under a fair value measure, as it's specified that the asset's residual values and useful lives are reviewed and adjusted if appropriate at each reporting period. And generally, the revaluation method would provide a more relative representation of the company's sizes and their value, specifically when it's released to PPE. This is because value of PPE is not fixed. Rather, they fluctuate significantly over their life. Therefore, by using the fair value approach, the value of assets are adjusted according to the market value and ensure that the value remains relevant for decision making. And this is our reference list, and thank you for watching.